What's up, guys? Welcome to the channel, Rockin' the Country. I'm Don. Hope you're having a good day. I'm doing a reaction today, which is what I normally do around here. If you're new to the channel, I do principally traditional music that people have requested. And I'm relatively new to traditional country. I've been reacting to it for about a year and a half now to 2 years. Prior to that, I was in the Nashville country for about 5 years. And prior to that, I was a rock guy. Punk rock, British rock, Southern rock. That was it. So anyway, a lot of these songs and artists are new to me. I did react to Riley Green's song, a different one. I don't know, maybe a year ago. Was it like Grandpa's? I Wish Grandpa's Never Died. And that was a hell of a song. But I'm doing Numbers on the Cars. And Riley's from Jacksonville, Alabama. And this is requested by Jordan Fox. So shout out to you, Jordan. Every so often, I'll stop the video. I don't overdo it, but it's a reaction video. So, you know, we do make comments. It also helps to not get blocked when we stop it once or twice. You know, copyright law actually requires, if you're going to use someone's stuff, that you substantially alter the song. And so stopping it does that, some, you know, and other things, you know, talking a little bit helps that too. But anyway, it's a little bit of background for you on copyright law. Here we go, Riley Green's Numbers on the Cars. I don't know it, so it's a reaction.
Stop by that house on Nesbitt Lake. He's sitting in his easy chair, watching the Sunday evening race. Tells me my grandma's in the other room. Guess he forgot we laid her down. It'll be a year come June.
Yikes.
Then he mumbles about Vietnam. He don't know who the hell I am, but the drivers, well, he tells me who they are. He still knows the numbers on the cars.
Wow, this has got to be a true story, because there is no way you would just be able to write that, stare at a blank page and say, I want to write something about my grandmother, my grandfather who, yeah, has Alzheimer's or dementia. This has to be real. Somebody's real story.
Try to get him out like we used to. Now I load the truck and I drive the boat, cause there ain't much he can do. Cast him a line and watched it as it sank. Thinking how he used to talk for hours, now he just stares at the bank. He used to know every stop in this fishing hole. Now he probably thinks that we're in Mexico, but he knows his way around that boat, even in the dark. But he still knows the numbers on the cars. Well, no, he ain't all there, but I don't care. My mind's still full of memories with him. And he may not know all the words to the song, but he still knows Merle Haggard's voice when he hears it.
That long-term memory.
Stop by that house on Nesbitt Lake.
Desmond Lake.
With a couple of tickets to go see a Sunday evening race. As we watch those cars fly around the track, I ask the Lord just one more time, you bring my old friend back. Then somewhere around lap 23, that old man turned and smiled at me, and for a moment I know he knows where we are. Cause he's still knows the numbers. He still knows the numbers. He still knows the numbers on the cars.
There's so much, and this is going to sound crass maybe, that I'm impressed with, like that just hit me. And as brilliant a depiction and capturing of his grandfather and the lyrics and the word nerd and all that I am, Bradley's heart for his grandfather, I don't know. You know, some people you say they must have been raised right, but I can't even, you know, that's not for me to say. I don't know him or his family, but there's something in his heart and in his mind that connects on that deep level. And it's a beautiful thing for me to see. You know, my family was fragmented in ways. And so when I hear a story like this about a love within the family for the grandfather, and the grandfather doesn't even recognize him, doesn't know who he is, and yet he goes and picks him up and he takes him and he does things to him. That's dedication. That's love. That's sweetness. That's beautiful. That's poignant. My stepfather passed away of dementia. Oh, this is going back now about 8 years or so, 7 years. And I remember the first time I realized he had it. And I don't know if it came on quickly, but I called him. And I called my mom and my stepdad, and we were talking on the phone for, I don't know, 10 minutes. And I don't know, football came in, and we were just laughing about stuff. And then sort of toward the end, as he's about to hand me off to my mom, he says, "Well, who's this?" And I was like, "Oh, okay." I'm like, "This is Don." I played it off laughingly, but he goes, "Oh, okay, here she is." But I realized right away, wow, I didn't even know he was sick up until that point and all that. So I can relate to a lot of this story, but that was beautiful. I'm not going to rate that. I mean, it's just an homage to his grandfather, you know. That's just beautiful, and I'm going to leave it at that. But, you know, the long-term memory, you know, the what are they, like neuroscientists, you know, people who study the brain and how memory works. And I've listened to some deep seminars on this stuff. I don't get it all, but just the way short-term memory and memory works and the reconstructive process of things. Long-term memory, like you can remember something 70 years ago if you're 80, but you can't remember your kids, you know, and that's a different issue too, but new things, you know, the person you just met, you don't even know that you just met them when your memory is gone, because it's not just the synapses that aren't firing right, but it's the cell walls that pass on the coded information, all of that stuff. It's just a heck of a thing to see happen to somebody. Understanding it helps a little bit, I guess, but all right. Jordan Fox, holy cow, man, thank you for that. If anybody else had recommended this and I missed it, thank you. I apologize and thank you, but that's it. Riley Green's numbers on the cars. I don't know. That's going to go on my classic playlist. My classic songs reviewed or reacted to, but not rated. There you go. It's got to be in there. This is just a beautiful song. So that's it. All right, guys. Hope you enjoyed that. Have a great day. See you on another video. Keep rocking the country.